This is the Large Hadron Collider, or LHC for short. It's a 27-kilometer particle accelerator sitting underneath the border of Switzerland. It's an atom smasher, biggest in the world, designed and built by thousands of engineers, scientists, and mathematicians across our tiny planet, with a goal of helping other scientists learn about things of incredibly small size by smashing them together. Smashing things together? Does that not remind you of that scene from Fried Green Tomatoes?
Tawanda.
This is the beam, which means bunches of hydrogen protons that fill up the LHC. The LHC is a ring containing two beams moving in opposite directions, but if you look closer, that beam is actually made up of bunches of protons. In fact, each bunch has about 100 billion protons, and these bunches here are about 30 centimeters long and a millimeter in diameter. Incredibly powerful superconducting magnets keep the beams flying at nearly the speed of light, the aim of making the proton bunches hit. The protons miss each other, and they come back around later to do it again. The reason why they miss each other is because atoms are mostly space, so getting them to collide is incredibly difficult. It would be like standing 10 kilometers apart and trying to shoot two needle-thin arrows at each other so they would meet and touch halfway. It's practically impossible. Unless, of course, you're Merida. But for us, the key is to do this a lot until finally the beams hit.
Merida.
The target for the LHC is 800 million collisions a second. 800 million collisions is freaking insane. Hundreds of millions per second is crazy. Imagine trying to control a proton traveling at the speed of light. To keep the bunches on track, the LHC uses dipole magnets, or tube magnets, but when they need to steer the protons, they use quadrupole magnets, or four. One for each compass point, applying 300 to 400 metric tons of force per meter. The LHC is sort of like your power company, but instead of providing electricity, they're generating collisions. More collisions, more better. They use all their effort to get these bunches of hydrogen ions to hit inside of other scientists' experiments. Of course, having a collision is great, but if a proton collides in the woods and no one's there, does that make a boson? Who knows? The scientists still have to be watching at just the right fraction of a second to discover a new particle. That's where these experiments come in. They sit on the LHC ring at the collision points, and they're probably what you think of when you hear Large Hadron Collider. The famous ones are Atlas and CMS, which spotted the famous boson back in 2013. Together, physicists call these hadrons. Hence the name, Large Hadron Collider. Proton collisions help physicists reveal exactly what these tiny structures that make up our universe are made of. The technology is super advanced, but the science is the same as it's always been. We simply break things apart, hoping to understand what makes them tick. Particle accelerators are cool, and if you don't believe me, watch this.
Initializing the prismatic accelerator. Approaching maximum power.
Thank you.
Congratulations, sir. You have created a new element. Sir, the reactor has accepted the modified core. I will begin running diagnostics.